Hi, this is Cheryl Walters, Logan's Reference and Electronic Resources Librarian. I'm going to walk you through how to use PubMed through Logan University Library. The first thing you want to do is access PubMed through the library's databases page. So go to the library's main website or the Learning Resource Center. Scroll down until you find the important links and then choose Databases. PubMed will appear in the top databases section. Now it's important to use the library's link to PubMed if you are a Logan student, staff, or faculty member, because this is going to allow you to access our full text subscriptions. PubMed is free for anyone to use at pubmed.gov, but this link is specifically set up to get you through to full text from us. So click on it, and when you're off campus, it will ask you to log in with your first name dot your last name and then the same password you use for Logan email. Now here's the main search box of PubMed, and we're just going to do a simple search for public health and policy. When you search in PubMed, it is beneficial to separate your concepts with AND because this allows the database to know how they relate to one another. So click search. Now your search results will be in the best match order. So PubMed is trying to determine what the best match for your search string is. You can change this if you like under display options. You can change this to most recent. You can also change it to display an abstract, a full abstract on this screen instead of a summary. Now if you want to leave it on best match, you can change the date range on the side here. Something I want to talk about is the text availability limiters here. When you limit your search results to free full text, you are just pulling back items that are free for everyone to access. If you do this, it's going to eliminate any of the paid journal subscriptions for which Logan subscribes, so I would not recommend doing that. And then this one, full text, is kind of misleading. This essentially just means that the publisher has provided a link from PubMed to their site. So they've said, hey, PubMed, it's okay for you to link to our site. Because PubMed is an abstract database. It doesn't actually contain full text within itself. It's going to link you to full text resources. So this sounds great, but I wouldn't use this either because it doesn't have anything to do with whether or not you can get that full text once you're on that site. So it's not going to tell you if you have Logan's full text access. Now, there isn't a way to limit all of your results just to Logan's items, unfortunately, but it is good to not do that if you're trying to be evidence informed, because you really want to look at all of the evidence that is available anyway. So we're just going to glance at a few of these to give you an idea of how to actually get full text. I'm going to go to this one here, and when I click on it, it will give me more detail for that record. So you're going to see the full abstract here and some similar articles. Now, the way that you find full text is right here where it says full text links. You're often going to see a publisher's link like this here has Duke University Press. You might also see like Elsevier or Ovid or something like that, but you want to look for the Logan University full text. So click on Logan University, and this is how you're going to find out if you have access to the full text. So when you do have full text, it's going to take you through to that full text resource. And when you get to that resource, you want to look for the PDF version. So in this case, the PDF is over here. So different sites are going to look different. You're just going to have to look around for that PDF version. Now, if we go back to our search results, and I'm going to show you one that we don't have. So I'm going to click here on number 6. And again, I'm going to go here to the Logan University icon. Now this article, we don't have full text access. So you're going to be greeted with this submit an interlibrary loan request. So you click on that. And the great thing about this is it's going to pre-populate all of the article information. So all you have to do is put your name, your last name, and your email address. So you need to use your Logan email address because we're going to be getting this from another library, and in order to stay copyright compliant, we have to send it to your Logan email address. Okay, so that should get you started with PubMed. When you need more help, please reach out to us by phone, by email at library@logan.edu, or send us a chat anytime.